So here I am, December 14th, 2011, and I'm speaking with our man and occupier, Justin James Bridges. So, man, you were just telling me about your medical bills because of the what happened during the eviction.
Yeah, I got my first bill back just from the hospital alone. It was over $22,000, and we actually I brought a copy of that up to City Council last week during my testimony. Yeah. Showed them that, and I mean, there's appointments that I'm getting into where I have to pay $200 deposit to be seen.
My God.
Yeah.
You have medical insurance?
No, I do not.
No, whoa.
Yeah, so. And I can't play guitar to make money right now.
You are a busker, right?
No, I play for a living. On the radio and I play for a living.
Okay, right on. Well, I wasn't meaning to be insulting. I mean, if you can actually busk and make money at it, it means you're a very talented musician because you can't make money doing that unless.
No, I love busking.
Oh, yeah.
But I do for my money is playing big shows.
So you're like a studio musician and that kind of stuff?
Yeah, and I play shows.
Cool. Awesome. How are your hands? Were your hands damaged?
My right arm, I don't have full feeling or movement in. I can move my index finger that much and my thumb that much. It's about all the money.
And you were telling me you got the 20 grand bill, and what did they diagnose you with?
They diagnosed me with low back pain.
Low back pain.
But since then, I've been to a couple other doctors, and I've been confirmed that I had a bunch of bone bruises. And I've also had, they're still trying to figure out what's wrong with my arm.
You might want to go to a doctor out of this county.
So I've been going to some really good doctors.
Okay.
The Doctors for Compassionate Care.
Okay, right on.
So,
cool.
A bunch of different really good.
You know, if you want to split the difference of your medical bill, if you pay me 10 grand, I can tell you you have back pain, you know. I mean, is there anything you want to add, brother?
Just go out and occupy.
Occupy.
Occupy everything.
And I was kind of inspired by your words at the GA. I wasn't there, but I got to see the video of it where you were actually saying, you know, you still have love in your heart, compassion in your heart for these police.
I do. Truly do.
If you had anything you could say to them, what would it be?
Love you.
All right, brother. You're a better man than me, man. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thousand miles from home, an American army is fighting for you. Everything you hold worthwhile is at stake. Only the hardest blows can win against the enemy we are fighting.
That's what the government does. It lies about things.
The United States is at war with
hardcore terrorists.
Yes, to a certain extent, yes.
With Islam.
Yes.
That's what the government does. It lies about things.
Do we kill these people?
Do I kill these strange people?
The policeman isn't there to create disorder. The policeman is there to preserve disorder.
And they're going
to
blow stuff up and say, see, we told you we're saving you.
Oh, the humanity.
That's what the government does. It lies about things.
The policeman isn't there to create disorder. The policeman is there to preserve disorder.
Do we kill these people?
Like kill these strange people?
There is only an American problem.
Do we kill these people?
Like kill these strange people?
Kill all Americans.